So in profile view or side view, see this. If this one is front view, if you are observing from the front view, and this one is top view, then for a first angle projection, this becomes left side view. Okay, so left side view is in first angle projection, you will get here. Okay, so front view you will get here, top view you get on the bottom horizontal plane, and left side view you will get on this plane. We call it as a auxiliary plane or profile plane. So how to make it align? You will rotate this plane. You will rotate this plane this way. So by rotating, you will get this view align with the front view. Okay, now see this, how we are going in getting it in a 2D plane. So this one is your first view or first front view, then top view was here, and we have rotated the this plane. See this dotted line as a horizontal plane. So when we have taken this plane downward, we will get the same. The nearer is, so our reference axis is this one, XY, or reference plane or reference axis. How do we get this reference axis? By when both horizontal plane and vertical plane, where these two plane cut, that is our reference axis this way. Okay, so next inside, now this one is your profile plane or auxiliary plane, and now you are getting this view. So this is left side view. So when you rotate this plane and make it align with the vertical plane, this one is your vertical plane. So make it align with vertical plane. So this becomes your side view. Okay. Okay, next, okay, so see this front view, view from the left and top view, and this symbol tells us that we have drawn in first angle projection. So what is the symbol for third angle projection? Same, just you take it two concentric circle and draw it this side. This becomes your third angle projection. It means this one is for first angle, and when you draw it, two circle and then this cone, this becomes triangle projection symbol. So merely by watching at this, you can tell that the projection have been drawn in first angle or third angle. Okay, so what is the concept? Third angle projection, plane is considered as in between object and observer. So this one is object, observer is here and plane in between. So we pull back the projection from the all the edges, corners, we pull back the projection on the plane. Same way for profile plane and same for, and again as you know, in third angle projection object is below the, this one is your horizontal plane. So object is below the horizontal plane, so you will pull back the projection. Okay, so here you will get the projection. Next, what will you do? You will rotate plane, make it align within the vertical plane so that you can easily draw it on 2D plane. So this is the concept in third angle projection. See that object projections, front end, front view and top view. Oh sorry, both are the front view, but this view has been drawn on this, pulling back in this way. Okay, but this one in third angle position, this is your view. You can back view, you can say this one is your back view, but this one is front view. How you have got this? By pulling back the projection from all the edges. This edge gives this projection, this edge, this slant edge is giving this projection, then this edge vertical, this is giving us this projection, and again this horizontal line giving us this projection, and then this line, say this is giving us only a point here, same this is giving us only a point here, again this vertical is giving us vertical line is giving us this projection, and again this vertical line, this projection, and this horizontal line, sorry, horizontal is giving us this projection. Same way take for the top view. So when you are going to draw top view, so this edge will give you only this much projection, and then vertical line, so only one point here, again this edge will give you this edge projection, this edge will give you this line projection, again this edge, this line, again this slant, slant surface of base is there, but the edge is at the this side, edge is horizontal, so this, again this top surface, this edge will give you this projection, again this is for this, again this like this one, this like there is a slant edge. The same way opposite side is also an slant edge, so that slant edge will give you a horizontal line, that projection, and this slant edge also will give you this horizontal line, and this edge will give you this horizontal line. So front view you this one, top view this one. So what will you do when you rotate the top plane, sorry, horizontal plane by 90 degree and make a line with the vertical plane, so this top view will automatically align with the front view. Okay, and now look for the side view. Side view, bottom edge will give you this. Okay, so let's talk about right side view. So when we talk about right side view, in third angle projection, we are talking about in third angle projection. So in right side view, this is because we will observe from this side, so this edge will be visible. Again, this slant edge, slant surface is also visible, so that will appear to you as a rectangular surface in projection, and then this end will appear you as a rectangular. So this way you will get the right side view. So now what you have to do, you have to make it align. So if this is your vertical plane and this one is your auxiliary plane or profile plane, so you need to make it align. So when you take it, so this plane will be like this way. Okay, and your projection would be like this way. Understand it. This plane we are rotating by 90 degree. This projection will come as a this point as this way, this point as here, this edge as here, this edge as here, this edge here. So it is like this. I'm moving to the next slide. So let's see. This is the view you are obtaining. We are pulling back front view, we are pulling back side view, and you are pulling back top view. This is a black arrow shows that your direction of views. So you are observing here and you are pulling back the projections. You are observing from tops and you are pulling back the projection. Same, you are observing from the right side again, pulling back the projection. I hope it is clear now. Again, although I have discussed this one, but again I am covering it. So in front view, see this. In front view, your vertical planes are behind the object. So you are projecting, not pulling back, you are actually projecting it. So here front view and left side view and top view. This is top view. So front view you will get, and what will you do for the left side view? You will get here, but you will rotate the plane because vertical plane and profile plane are at 90 degree. 90 degree. So you will rotate by 90 degree so that this can come in a, this can align with the vertical plane. Okay, so in first angle you will rotate this way, so you will get this this kind of projection, and again in top view you will get this way on this projection. So you will rotate again, as you know both plane are 90 degree, so you will rotate downward 90 degree so that it can align with the vertical plane. So this is your horizontal plane and this one is your vertical plane and this is your profile plane. But what we do in third angle projection, as we know in third angle projection object is behind the planes. So actually the planes we are taking that are transparent in third angle projection. So we can consider it that planes are in between observer and object. So that's why you need to pull back projections. Instead of like you were projecting in on the plane, but here you have to pull back. You are projecting, it means your projection was going away from the observer, but here you are taking the projection towards the observer because plane is in between the object and observer. So you are pulling back the projection. Same way you will pull back the projection in top view, and same way if this one left hand side view or left side view, you will pull back the projection this way. See the difference between left or side views in first angle and third angle. In first angle you are projecting here and you are rotating, so left side view you will get the right of the object, right of the front view. Okay, in first angle projection you will get left side view in the right side of the front view, but in third angle projection you will get left side view in the left side. So it is like unfolding a box. You will open this surface, or say sorry, this way side view profile plane in this way, and you will open like box in opposite direction, and front view you will pull back. So do we take right side view or left side view for specific cases in the third angle projection, or can we take any, or do we take one of them? So this is a good question. In question you can be asked to draw left side view and right side view both, but generally one view is necessary. One view either left side view or right side view is enough, since we will draw front view or top view. But now we have to draw either left side view or right side view. It will be asked to you that draw left side view and right side view, because you are when you are learning the concepts, so it can be asked to draw left side view and right side view both. Okay, but once you are adept to the concepts, so only one view, either left side or either right side, will be asked. There is no necessity, you have to draw only based on the question, the way the question has been asked. Just wait a minute. I hope I have cleared your doubt. Now I have discussed this in lecture 2 video, Okay, so I am moving to the next slide. Because I have discussed everything in the lecture 2, so you can watch it there. So lecture 3 starts here mainly. Again, folding and unfolding. Now you have got the concept. We have to unfold in third angle projection this way, and top. So you will always get top view in third angle projection. Top view you will get above the front view. Okay, and in first angle projection you will get top view below the front view. Now you can tell me why this is happening, because the way we have taken the object. Okay, so in this, here we are projecting on the plane and here we are pulling on the plane, so that's why. Now you can ask, sir, in India which type of projection we use, third angle or first angle projection? See, generally Australia and USA uses third angle projection. Australia and USA, so around 1950s, that time third angle projection were popular in USA and Australia, and in India, since Britishers were here, so they were using first angle projection. Then there comes a time that Government Bureau of Indian Standard that recommended that use the for the usage of third angle projection. Then next, again BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards, have directed that India should use first angle projection. Reason is because the whatever design we were getting around 1950s, that was mainly from the UK. So present day we are mainly dealing with the design with the Europeans like France, Germany, Italy, Spain, Britain. So that's why we and this country prefer first angle projection. So Government of India, that body covered, Bureau of Indian Standards, has recommended to use first angle projection. But we need to know both first angle projection and third angle projection. So now this two exercises, I'm going to tell you how to develop side view. So already you have front view and top view. So what will you do? This distance Parikshit, you are asking me that, sir, why do we don't use second and fourth angle projection? Parikshit, at the start of this lecture I told you that second and fourth angle projection overlaps, so it becomes difficult to differentiate which one is first angle, which one is front view, top view. That's why. And if the object is complex, having many numbers of edges, like say 10, 20 edges, and then in that case it will become very complex, very tedious to identify the edges. To avoid those misunderstanding and confusion, we use third and first angle projection. So if this one is your first angle projection, this one is front view and this one is top view. Okay, so if you are getting bored, then you can tell me, I will stop it, because I have crossed already 30-35 minutes marks. So here, from front view and top view, can we develop the side view? Yes. So for that, what we have to do, we have to take a fixed distance and draw a line, and we can call it miter line. Again, either you will take it this line or take any line and extend it. Okay, both are the both ways you can draw it. So just remember front view and top view, which one is front view, which one is top view. So here in particular case we have drawn this line, miter line, and then we will extend it, and from this point again we will draw another miter line at 45 degree angle. So you can ask me what is miter line. Miter lenses are used to obtain the third angle or third view from the first and from the two views. So to get the third view we use these two line, and these lines are called miter line. So next you will extend this one, again you will extend this is, and here you will extend the center of the hole here, and this edge you will extend here, and you will extend up to the this 45 degree line that you are calling it miter line, and then you will, after cutting it here, you will extend upward. Actually what you are doing, you are bending the line by 90 degree, you are bending the projection by 90 degree. So next you will extend this line, and then this is you will extend, and then you will extend this is. Now you have to identify which one is your projection. So from front view I am showing it. Now you have got all the lines. Now you need to know which one is your front view. You have got all the lines. Okay, so I will use different color. Now see, in front view this is the height of the object, total height of the object, but in top view you see there is something only up to this length. So you will extend this, it getting mixed. See, we have got this one. See, in top view we are observing that there is a this rectangular surface, and okay, and the height of that rectangular surface is this one. So in side view you will observe this much thickness of the this rectangular this solid. So that is the thickness. Now you check it, the same thickness is coming it this way, transferring it in the side view, because the lines are parallel, so the thickness would be constant, and that's why you are getting it. Height it is fixed, and location why it is not here, because you are taking it from this way. Again you see in top view two holes, circular holes are visible, and here you have shown it by hidden line. Okay, so now you see the center of the hole goes here, and inside view when we observe inside view only one hole will appear as hidden, only one hole will appear because another hole will hidden behind the front hole. So that's why you will draw this hole. Now since you are the diameter of the hole would be the same in both cases, either you observe it from the front view, from this way front view, or from the side view. So only you take the center line, up extended, that's why you see the center line and extended, and then diameter of the hole is constant. So take the diameter and draw the hole. So you see, that's why you see these two hidden lines, and as you see the front view thickness is this way and bottom surface or flat surface is like this. So inside view, that is your width of the this width is transferring in the side view. See, the total width is transferring in side view. Oh, tell me, till now have you got this or not? Do comment it. Tell me in the comment box, one or two person. If you have got the idea, then I will move to the next slide. Okay, so now if you have any confusion, you can message me, you can indirectly in chat box. That's a okay. One question, sir, how we have determined d? That is arbitrary, the value of d is arbitrary, we can take any distance, but it should be not coinciding with the edges of these two views, front view and top view. So now see this, we have front view and side view, and we are going to draw the top view from this. So again we will draw a miter line. So to draw, I will show you the two way. So in first way, you will draw a vertical line, and from here you will draw a 45 degree line, this line. Okay, now you will extend, you will drop the projection from the side view. Why not here? Because top view and front view are aligned, and side view are either left side or right side. That's why you need to draw the top view somewhere here. So you will drop it here, projector's lines, and again you will take it here this way. Okay, so when you extend it this way, you will get the limits for the top view. Another way is using the miter line to draw this miter line, then at 45 degree, and then take this as a center and take this as a radius and draw the arc this way. So you will get automatically the same point you will reach. Another, then take measure this way, this length, and draw the arc, you will reach here, and from here you can extend the horizontal projections. Again take this center here, measure this distance and draw the arc, and from here you draw the projections. Again take this as a center and take the length from here to here and draw the arc, and from here you draw the straight line. Again, next, drop the projection from the front view. This way you need to determine the respective position of the points, and third here. So in this case, what has been done? First one line has been drawn, and then from that line a miter line. This one is also miter line, this one is 45 degree also miter line. So we have drawn the projection on this 45 degree line, we have projected it, and then from here we have turned horizontal. So after turning horizontal, we will get. Now we need to know the top views. Or see in side view. Side view, you see a triangular shape here, and in top view, you see this shape, rectangular shape. So it would be kind of like this. Like this, that is attached on this way. Next is how to determine this length. This length is this much. How will you get? When you drop the projection from top to down, you will automatically get. So this is already here, so you see this, that's why this projection you see. So that is the difference. Again, this length, what is the end? So you see, in for end, you see this projector lines coming here, and when you will extend, you will get this end. For this, see this, for this you will draw this one, this end I am talking about, this end you will draw this projector line, then you will extend it, and then you will get it. So you will get this. Same for this. Okay, and now in front view you see this, and top view or inside view you see this is a rectangular section. So that's why you see one thing is missing. Because missing is this line should be thick, because this is contour and this is continuous, so it should be continuous thick line outline. And here, because see the in top surface, this one, this line would be projector line as light line, because this is not our outline. In top view, surface is like this. How this tells us surface is, top surface is rectangular. I hope you have got the fair understanding of this concept. So if you have got, just tell me yes or no. So I will start this slide. That is another example to draw front view and top view. Reply me in the chat box. Okay, so now we are here. This is two different questions. So first question is this this object. We call it as a pictorial view. So this pictorial view, we are given object 1 and object 2. So how to identify which one is on which direction we should observe? So there should be an arrow, this arrow and this arrow. These two arrows tell us that we have to observe from this direction. So that directly becomes your front view. Okay, so this is your front view. Front view. So now the dimensions are visible to you. So what are the edges or surfaces visible to you? I am just marking it here. So only that you will draw in the first angle projection. This, okay, this line will appear as a point to you in first angle projection. So again, from here, again this edge, this top edge, this edge, again this edge, again this will appear as a point. So this corner and this corner will overlap. Ultimately this line, projection of this line become points, and it will coincide with the this two projection of the corners. Oh yes, these two corner projections. Then this is, again this is 90 degree to this edge, so it will appear as a only a point this corner. Again this will appear this corner as a point here. Again this edge will appear, and again this edge will appear you as a point. Next, this edge will appear to your eyes. This edge will appear again. This edge will appear as a point, because this edge is 90 degree to the this edge. Okay, that's why I am not drawing. Those are 90 degree, I am not drawing here. Okay, so this corner and this corner will overlap, and projection of this line also overlap. So this edge will appear. So it is for this one. Again, this will also appear. So this edge will appear somewhere here, in behind this edge, this corner. But this line will appear because it is visible to your eyes. Again, this edge will appear, and this edge will hide behind this outline. So you will not draw this one. Again, this edge will hide behind the line that you will draw from top to this length, and it will automatically hide behind that. Again, as you know, this will appear as a point, so it will be overlap this with this corner and this corner. So that which are not appearing as an edge, I am showing with this mark. So you have drawn, you have got the edges in the front view. So what will you do? That is the, you know the dimension of this, all these lines. So height for this height 20 is given. I am marking the area that you will draw. This is your front view. Now the dimensions of each surfaces are clear to everyone. So you will draw again this one. I have missed this one. This edge will also appear, this edge. So you will draw, and this will be behind that or this edge. So this is the projection of your front view. So you will draw the reference line, and then based on the dimension you will draw. First you will draw the total length. What is total length? 60 plus 30, that is 90 degree or 90. So from here to here length should be 90. What is the height? 20 plus 20, 40 height. So you will draw 40 height line. So you will draw 40 mm. This becomes, this is your 90 from here to here. And from here to here it is 40. Now see, you have to use the dimension line this way. Okay, but now this is your limit in which your first angle and third angle projection will fall. So first angle projection, what is the this 20 20, and then this way from here to here, and then what the this thickness, this thickness is 10. Again you will draw 10 at what length? 30, and 30 plus 40 70. So this length, it is only merely you have to draw based on the dimension. This would be 70 and height would be 40 here, and this side at 40 you will draw this line. So you have drawn this. Okay, what is the 60 mm? Then you will draw this one 60 mm. You have drawn this also. Then you have drawn this also. This one is left. So height is 20 and 10 30. So 30 height, and it is starting from 30 40 to 60 30. So it will start from here. So this is your front view I have shown. Okay, same, it is clear. If it is clear, then I will show the top view only with the color. Oh, okay, I will finish in within 5 minutes. So in top view I will use which color? Red color. So in top view, what will you observe when you observe from this way? So I am talking about first angle projection. So in first angle projection you will observe this surface, rectangular top surface, and again this rectangular top surface, and again this flat surface, and this flat surface. only you will observe. Now you have to draw this surface according to the dimension. So what will you do? You will take again just below the reference line, say this one, you will take the 90 in top. You see the 90 length, that is 60 30, total 90 length will be fixed. So you will draw your top view in that limits. So that is 90 unit, and then what is the width in top view? Width is visible. So this one is 20 and 30, total 50. So you will mark from here to here 50 unit. So this is your limit for the top view. Now when you are drawing first angle projection, so this becomes your near edge. So you will start drawing from near edge this. So it will appear you as a straight line, then this 20 mm and 30, or this I am talking about this 20 and 30 rectangular. So 30 this and 20, this would be 20 and this would be 30. So again this length 40, from here to here 40, and this is, what is this length? 20. See, this is 20. So again you will draw 20. So you have drawn this one, you have drawn this one and this one, and you will draw this one. So it will appear, this edge will appear here. And now this is at what length? 60, from here to here 60, and it will appear, and this length 20, so it will go 20 inside, and then it will come here, and this way this is your. So I am using different color. So it would be like this. In particular figure, there is someone is asking, sir, we have to use dotted line. See, dotted line you use only where you have to show the hidden edges are hidden edges, especially hidden edges. So if the hidden edges are there, then you have to show, otherwise no use. So this is your this one is also, this is your front view, this one is your top view. Same you can consider to draw the left side view. So to left side view, if it is first angle projection, as you know, if it is first angle, so you will draw left side view in right side and right side view in left side. So now tell me in which view we should draw so that maximum edges are visible. This one is when you are observing from here, that left side view, and when you observe from this direction, that is right side view. So based on this figure, tell me that which direction we should view so that maximum edges are visible. Reply me in comment box, and in 1 minute I will finish. Exactly, right side view. Kuldeep Rai, right answer. Akash, right side view. Excellent, because the maximum edges are visible so that we can draw it. So we will draw right side view. And again, as you know, to draw the right side view, and once, since you are drawing right side view, so it will appear in first angle, you are drawing first angle projection. So in right side view, it will appear left side. So what we have to do? You have to extend this this projector lines, extend it, and then again what you have to do, you have to draw a miter line at 45 degree angle, and then you have to project it like you learned in previous slide, and project it downward and identify the various edges corners and set it. Another way, I am telling you that only these surfaces are visible in right side view. Only these surfaces are visible. So your right side view, take the projection from here and draw it. So from here, this edge would be this left, and this edge would be right, and bottom would be bottom, and this edge limit, what is the limit? 30 plus 20, 50. So width would be 50, this would be 50, and height is 20, 20, 40. So height would be 40, and then you will draw the projection. Okay, and then like this. So I am going to hash it. So you will get for this is this surface, this, and this surface, this, and this surface, this, and for this surface, this area. So your outline is this one. This one is your outline. Okay. So I am finishing it here. So what you have to do, you have to draw in third angle position. What you have to do, first angle, front view in third angle, the same. Here what you have drawn, left side view, right side view in third angle position, it will become the left side view or in third angle projection. Here you have drawn right side view, okay, but when you draw the third angle in third angle projection, same view will appear as a left side view in third angle projection. And top view, like you have drawn in first angle projection, at the below the front view, just take that position and simply put it, do not turn, do not rotate, just take that projection, whatever projection you have got, the same way, pick it and put it at the top of the front view. That becomes your third top view in third angle projection. So I hope now what you have to do for this, you have to complete the first angle projection, left side view, first front view, top view, and right side view in first angle projection, and left side view, top view and front view in third angle projection. This you have to do as a homework, and with that I am finishing here. I hope you have got the ideas, although I said that I will take 5 minutes, but I completely engrossed in this concept. So I hope you have got the understanding. With that I will finish it here.